One of Cubase's super strengths is its super realistic time stretching algorithms. And in this video, I'm going to take you through a few of them and show you how you can easily access them just by using these two simple samples right here. First of all, we need to make sure that we've got this little button right here selected, and that puts us in musical mode, which locks us into the Cubase tempo and basically means these tracks will instantly follow whatever tempo we set. So there it is, slower, and it sounds really, really good. Let's speed it up by 30. Once again, it sounds great. Now, one of the key things about time stretching in Cubase is that you can actually change the settings. If you go up to Media and open Pool Window, you can see these two files right here. And if we go to the right, under Algorithm, you can see all of the different types of pitch and time shifting algorithms that we have access to. And we're using the Elastique settings in this video. Now, let's do something like add a tempo track. So all I need to do is select tempo and add track, and I'm making sure that's set to ramp. And now I can just grab the pencil from my toolkit or right mouse click in my toolbox and put two dots in here, and let's put another one in and let's lower the tempo. So now we're drawing in a tempo change, and you can see that I'm locked into my grid, so it's easy to move these dots around in a musical fashion. Now that is a massive, massive tempo change, and it's still sounding pretty decent. The other thing I can do is have effects which are basically in sync with my track also slow down. So for example, this stereo delay is in sync. As my track slows down, so does the delay, which is even cooler. So it basically means that everything is going to be in sync with my tempo. If I want to, I can basically do the opposite and have the track speed up. So at the moment, we're not actually on the highest quality Elastic audio settings, and we can go into the Pool window and we can fine tune this a little bit more. For example, anything musical, we could allocate to pitch. And anything which is beat or drum or percussion related or time related, we could allocate to time. Now you'll notice that there's a few different settings in there. At the moment, we're only on the middle quality setting. So the formant quality is really the highest quality. And look, I'm gonna play this for you. This is with pitch and time allocated. Let's have a listen. And look, to be honest, I don't think anyone's really going to notice the difference over YouTube. It's really going to be what sounds best for the track that you've got in front of you with the headphones on. What I do know, however, is that once we move to tape, we get a completely different style of effect. Have a listen to this. So most of you will have noticed that what's actually going on here is an old school tape style effect. So as the tape slows down, the pitch lowers. As the tape speeds up, the pitch obviously gets higher. And there's loads of really cool things that we can do with the tape based algorithm. So you can mix and match between a number of different algorithms. If we go back into the actual menu and you have a look, you can see that there's three different sections there. The top one's the medium, the formant is the highest quality, and the bottom one's the lowest quality. And then if we go back into the menu, all of these standard settings are the old Cubase pitch shifting settings, which are still really good, just different. Once again, it's a matter of using your own ears. Thanks for taking the time to stop by and check out this video. There's plenty of videos on the Cubase YouTube channel which show you how you can audio stretch and of course make tempo changes in your entire music production. So don't forget to subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel and give us a thumbs up if you've learned something. Catch you soon.